Hello, it's Luis Sainz, and this is the first part about the impact of harmonics in electrical installations. In this video, I will explain the impact of harmonics in capacitors. Harmonics can produce different issues in electrical installations, and this video presents their influence in capacitors. Harmonics may produce an overloading of capacitors because the harmonic currents going through these capacitors depend on the harmonic voltages and the harmonic reactance of the capacitor, which decrease with the harmonic order of the voltages. So, these harmonic currents flowing through the capacitor bank would directly depend on the harmonic voltage distortion and the harmonic order. And these harmonic currents increase the Rodman square value of the harmonic of the capacitor current. If the supply voltage does not contain harmonics, the Rodman square value of the capacitor current is equal to the fundamental current. While if the supply voltage contains harmonics, the capacitor current depends on the fundamental current by a factor depending on the square of the harmonic order and the harmonic voltage distortion. The greater is the harmonic voltage distortion, the greater is the capacitor current, which may produce the overloading of the capacitor banks. Harmonics can also produce an increase of capacitor power losses. The equivalent circuit of a capacitor has a resistance of high value connected in parallel with the capacitor. The losses in this resistance is the sum of the harmonic voltage square divided by the resistance. By using the loss tangent of the capacitor, we can observe that the losses in this capacitor depend on the harmonic content of the supply voltage. Broadly speaking, the loss tangent is small because the resistance is high, and then the losses in the capacitor are also small. The third effect on capacitors related to harmonics is the resonance phenomenon. Imagine that we have a capacitor bank to compensate the reactive power of an electrical installation, and there is a nonlinear load connected in this installation. If we want to calculate the harmonic voltage distortion at the nonlinear load terminals by means of the approach presented in the videos about the resolution of harmonic problems, we must work with this harmonic equivalent circuit. And then the harmonic voltages are equal to the equivalent impedance of the parallel between the grid and the capacitor reactances by the harmonic currents consumed by the nonlinear load. We can observe that for this harmonic, the denominator of the equivalent impedance becomes zero. And then this equivalent impedance becomes infinite at this harmonic. So, at this harmonic, the value of the harmonic voltages are also infinite. We have a parallel resonance phenomenon at this harmonic, which is related to a maximum of the equivalent impedance, and it may produce high values of the harmonic voltages. These high values may increase the harmonic overloading and power losses of the capacitors. The harmonic of this resonance can also be calculated from the short circuit power of the grid and the reactive power of the capacitor bank. And the resonance frequency can be determined from this harmonic and the fundamental frequency of the installation. As an example, we have a nonlinear load and a capacitor bank fed by a sinusoidal grid, and we are going to calculate the harmonic voltage at the nonlinear load terminals and study the resonance phenomenon. According to the videos about the harmonic problem resolution, we divide the study in the fundamental and the harmonic circuits. For the fundamental, we determine the voltage at the nonlinear load terminals approximated to the supply voltage, the fundamental current consumed by the nonlinear load, and the reactance of the capacitor bank from its reactive power consumption. For the harmonics, we have this harmonic equivalent circuit, and first we determine the harmonic currents of the nonlinear load from the harmonic current spectrum and the fundamental current. And we multiply the equivalent impedance of the parallel between the reactance of the grid and the reactance of the capacitor by these harmonic currents, the harmonic currents consumed by the nonlinear loads, in order to obtain the harmonic voltages. We observe that these harmonic voltages, or the corresponding individual harmonic voltage distortion, presents a height value at the fifth harmonic. This is due to a parallel resonance produced between the grid and the reactance of the capacitor at the frequency of 288 Hz. The increase of the harmonic voltages due to this resonance at the fifth harmonic may produce the overloading and the overheating problems in the capacitor bank.